Recently, Imam al-Mutawa gave a sermon at the White Mosque in Gaza. The White Mosque was apparently named in honor of the skin color of Muhammad. Imam al-Mutawa uses his sermon to praise the great God Allah for sending his latest soldier, coronavirus.
Subhanahu yursilu jundiyan wahidan fa kayfa law kanat 50 min corona jundiyan wahidan fa asabat al-wilayat al-50 asabat al-wilayat al-50 qabla sa'a ala al-fadaiya. يقول في كاليفورنيا نتوقع خلال شهرين 58% من كاليفورنيا أحدثك عن أكثر من 25 مليون إصابة يتوقعون في ولاية واحدة من الخمسين سبحان الله.
Then he starts bragging that whereas Israelis are staying at home to avoid spreading the virus, Muslims are gathering together because they know Allah is protecting them.
انظر كيف مدنهم خاوية انظر كيف شوارعهم خالية وانظر هذا الجامع العامر بهذا العدد الهائل من الذي أمننا وأرعبهم من الذي حمانا وأفزعهم إنه الله.
Who's protecting the Muslims?
Allah.
Who?
Allah.
Next, this beacon of peace and love asks Allah to continue protecting Muslims and to keep infecting the enemies of Islam.
Allahumma adfa'hu anna warfa'hu anna wasrifhu anna wasallithu ala jama'at safqat ash-sharr ajma'in.
Interestingly, Imam al-Mutawa puts Iran in the same category with Italy and China. Iran is a Shia Muslim country, and the Imam counts Shias among the enemies of Allah who are being punished by coronavirus.
إخواني هل كورونا حقيقة نعم هل كورونا يعدي نعم هل كورونا يقتل نعم هل في ناس عندها كورونا سبحان الله. أرقام إيطاليا 450 أمس ضحية كل 8 دقائق ضحية أرقام إيران كل 8 دقائق ضحية أرقام الصين تأتي بعد إيطاليا 3300 ضحية ما الذي يجري سبحان الله إنها عظمة الله.
Who's protecting the Muslims?
الله.
Who?
الله. أقل بلاد العالم إصابة هم أهل الإسلام والبلد الوحيد الذي لم يمت فيه حالة أنا داخل في جامعكم وإذا رسالة 56 حالة من التي كانت في بيت لحم محجوزة شفيت بفضل الله تماما إخواني وأحبابي الكرام حتى قبل دخولي الجامع أتواصل مع المسؤولين الأطباء الجواب إلى اللحظة غزة ليس فيها حالة واحدة.
Not a single case in Gaza because Allah is protecting Muslims. The very next day after this sermon, however, two cases of coronavirus were confirmed in Gaza. A few days later, 7 more coronavirus cases confirmed in Gaza. Palestinian sources said the new 7 patients were members of the Hamas security forces who were staying with the 2 original infected patients at a quarantine center. When we first heard about coronavirus in China, we heard imams around the world proclaiming that coronavirus was Allah's punishment on China for China's treatment of the Uyghurs. Then the disease started spreading to countries outside of China, which suggested that if Allah was trying to punish the Chinese, he's got really bad aim. Obviously, the disease is going to spread most rapidly to areas with lots of flight traffic. The more planes you have flying between 2 countries, one of which has an outbreak of a contagious disease, the greater the risk that the disease will spread to the other country. Needless to say, there aren't a lot of flights to Gaza from anywhere. What conclusion should we draw? That Allah is protecting Gaza from coronavirus.
Gaza ليس فيها حالة واحدة.
Then coronavirus spreads to Gaza. Keep in mind, this is a disease that, not long ago, was Allah's soldier against the Chinese. Now it's attacking Hamas. Does Allah have really terrible aim, or is Hamas also the enemy of Allah? Imams of the world, I know you don't like me, but even if you don't like me, you can at least take one piece of advice, human being to human being. When it comes to coronavirus, just shut up. Stop trying to prove that Allah's on your side by pointing to a disease that's just getting started. But David, you keep posting videos about Muhammad and coronavirus, so you're not shutting up. I don't know if anyone noticed, but I was keeping my mouth shut about Muhammad and coronavirus. I was being nice, because people are dying, and this is a good time for everyone to get along and work together. But every single day, I had to wake up to 487 messages from Muslims telling me that something about coronavirus proves something about Islam. And eventually, I couldn't take it anymore. But it's even worse with people like Imam al-Mutawa, who encourages Muslims to gather together in large groups to show their faith in Allah. Muslim men and women are going to die because of morons like this. The amazing part is that when I tell these same Muslims, look, most young people are going to be okay, old people not so much, so keep old people away from the young people. Don't gather in large groups. Even if we're all going to get coronavirus, we want the process to be slow so that hospitals aren't overwhelmed and so that doctors have as much time as possible to research different treatments. These same Muslims will call me their enemy for wanting to save lives. But the guy who's going to get them all infected before hospitals are even prepared, leading to countless pointless deaths, he's their friend. Welcome to Islam, where up is down and down is up, where left is right and right is left, where right is wrong and wrong is right, where smart is stupid and stupid is smart, where friends are enemies and enemies are friends, and where Muhammad is a true prophet. In other words, opposite world.